Welcome to this week's video, everybody. My name is Chris.
I'm Jolene.
And welcome to our 1 year anniversary of living on a boat. Labor Day 2020. Today was supposed to be my last day of work before we push off and head to the boatyard and then head out on our adventure. I don't know if you can see, but it is raining. We've had quite a few storms and our morning is canceled. We'll see if we can get an afternoon trip in or not. It's been a crazy year. We've bought the boat and put it in the water almost a year ago to the day, right?
Mm-hmm.
And went and got this job just as we were in the process of buying the boat, and I was sitting around because it took us like a month and a half to get everything closed. And Jolene got tired of me in the hotel. She's like, go get a job. Okay, I'm going to go do something that would be fun. And it was. I learned how to be a mate on a parasail captain, learned how to be a mate on a parasail boat. I've collected enough hours for my captain's license. Got SNUPA certified, so I can take that with me. It's been a great experience. I really, really appreciate George and Cindy and the company that they run down at Sundance Water Sports. And if you guys are ever in the Keys and looking for a great time, definitely check out Sundance Water Sports. They do parasailing, they do snorkeling, they do scuba diving. And they put on a really good show, really nice equipment, really nice boats. So thanks guys. We really appreciate the opportunity and everything that I've learned from you guys. All the crew members, the other captains, the other mates. Definitely gonna have some, I would say, some long-term friends from all of you guys. So thank you. One of the neat benefits of the job that I had and the people that I worked for, we got a couple of times over the last year to go out on their big, huge commercial catamaran that they use for taking people snorkeling. And they let us do a couple of crew trips on days where we were open and ready to run, but nobody booked. So this last, about a week and a half ago, we had one of those days. The season's coming to an end, so during the week it's gotten really slow. And we got to go, we're trying to go spearfishing. Nobody shot anything. Did a little bit of lobstering, got to dive with Chase, everybody got to go snorkeling. It was a great time, so check it out. I love watching rain on the water. Thank you.
is raining. Should be a fun last day at work.
Well, it's dumping rain right now, but they're going to try and run an afternoon trip. So, I'm going to get the boat ready, get the snooba gear together. One last day at work, and then we're out of here tomorrow.
Making some homemade pizza.
Oh, we put extra cheese.
Yeah.
Bubbly
pizza. So because it's our 1 year of living on a boat.
1 whole year.
What, Chase, are some of the things you remember the most about living in Isla Mirada on a boat?
I really love getting dive certified and diving my first time.
Yes, that's good. Carter, what's one of your favorite things?
Getting boat certified and making new friends.
Making new friends, yeah.
And boat certified meaning like I'm allowed to drive the dinghy now.
What about you, Caleb?
Caleb, what's one thing or some things you liked the most about living on a boat for 1 year?
Caleb, what up? That the cats, they don't have to, that I don't have to search the whole building 80 times to find one of them.
Nice. All right, babe, what's one thing you like the most about living on our boat for a year?
I like the adventure, and yes. I like how everything is new. I get tired and bored of the same thing. So
rat race.
Yeah, a year here was perfect.
Yep.
And then I'm ready to go on to the next thing.
Yeah.
And try something new and figure it out.
Yep.
How about you?
What I love most about living on a boat is the sense of accomplishment. Like we said we would, and we did. The thing I like most about Isla Mirada is the friends. The church and the friends and the community. Like, we met a great boat community. And
that's what I said, too.
Yeah. It's been great.
One of the other questions are, what's been hard to adjust to on a boat? Mine is always having to make new friends everywhere we go, because it's hard to always leave our friends. So, it's, I just always miss our friends. Another question is, what do you wish you had on a boat? Some other stuff we wish we had was more of our Legos from our storage in Oregon.
Grandpa and Grandma, hint, hint.
Ship your Legos.
Yeah. And also,
as much Legos also, as you can, Grandma and Grandpa.
And also, I kind of want a board game that we've been learning about recently, Villainous. It has many different things, and it's really fun. I just wish we had it.
So there's not much that you don't have.
Not too much that we don't want on the boat.
Yeah. Legos,
literally plays Legos all the time. And Villainous, it's a nice board game that, like, it's kind of like one of our pizza game. It's kind of like one of our other board games, but it's more, like, easier to set up and everything.
Who's is that?
Carter, half Caleb.
Yeah. Carter, you like all those mushrooms?
No, that's Caleb.
What we learned over the past year is it's not about the destination, but the journey. Plans don't always go the way that we hope. Our year in Isla Mirada has produced memories, adventures, and lifelong friends. If things had gone according to our plan, we would have bought a sailboat in Tampa and headed to the Caribbean the winter of 2019. No matter your journey, take time to enjoy each moment. Enjoy the journey.
Thank you, patrons, for keep on sending us more stuff. Thank you, Daniel Bell and Dave Bell, for sending us our cookie cutters, our portable radio,
And also a portable DVD player. Thank you, thank you, thank you. This is just amazing.
Kitty cookie, Kevin?
Yeah, those are your kitty cookies.
Hey, I want to see.
Thanks for this book. Thank you, Danielle Bell, for getting us some books. We've updated our Amazon wish list, and check the link below, description below, for more ways to support us. Like, share, and subscribe, and also, have a good day. Bye.
Thanks for the books.
We feel super, super blessed. I just want to say thank you so much to all of our wonderful patrons and supporters, Dave and Danielle, Mike and Linda, and Steve. Thank you so much for all the stuff. We got books for the kiddos. They've already read them. They love the Dogman books. That is our youngest son's favorite. Got our flags for checking in on our country, some dive lights, a case for the drone that we got from our patrons a few weeks ago. Super blessed. We cannot tell you how much we appreciate it. This is the kind of stuff that really makes us, gives us the juice to keep doing the videos and sharing our lives with people. And just to know that you appreciate it enough to care about us. And it just makes us feel loved and humbled, and we're really, really grateful. For those of you that are wondering, we do try and keep the Amazon wish list updated for things that would be helpful for us. So if that's how you want to support us, awesome. We also have a Patreon page, so feel free to check that out as well. All the links that you could possibly want, all the things that we're doing, are all below in the description. So check that out. Thanks again for our support. Keep watching. We'll see you guys next week.
Join us next week on our journey as we leave Isla Mirada and we cruise to Key West to finally pull out and repair some damage that we incurred while running aground.